It's Saturday. Welcome to Daily Prayers. However you've spent your time this week, I hope that you have been conscious of God's presence with you through your relationship with Jesus. As we come to him now, we remember that he is always with us, shining his light in our lives. O Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. Blessed are you, God of compassion and mercy. To you be praise and glory forever. In the darkness of our sin, your light breaks forth like the dawn, and your healing springs up for deliverance. As we rejoice in the gift of your saving help, sustain us with your bountiful spirit and open our lips to sing your praise. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Blessed be God forever. Amen. We move on in our Bible passage to the first temptation. So we're in Luke chapter 4, beginning at verse 3. The devil said to Jesus, "If you are the Son of God, tell this stone to become bread." Jesus answered, "It is written, man shall not live on bread alone." Chapter 3 of Luke has very clearly set Jesus up as the Son of God. He's heard a voice from heaven announcing that he is God's dearly loved Son. But now in chapter 4, he is very clearly seen as Jesus the man. He's hungry and he's tired. Will he begin to doubt what he has heard? If he continues to believe that he is God's son, will he feel the need to prove it to others? The devil comes with what seems at first to be a reasonable suggestion. You're hungry, there's no food around, but that shouldn't be a problem to the Son of God. Just use your power to turn these stones into bread. God's not going to want you to starve in the desert, is what I hear in my head as I see this temptation. Jesus doesn't have to prove anything to himself or anyone else. He's sure of his relationship with the Father. He uses the book of Deuteronomy in the Old Testament to answer the devil, as he does with each of the following temptations. Deuteronomy effectively means second law. God's laws are told again to the Israelites as they're about to enter the land that God had promised them. It was the law God gave for people to live by. In his humanity, Jesus knows that obedience to God comes even before feeding himself. He doesn't use his power as a get-out-of-jail-free card to get himself out of tricky situations. He stands with us in our weakness and uses God's word and the certainty of his relationship with his Father God to resist this temptation. God had provided for the Israelites on their own journey through the desert, as described in Deuteronomy. He would provide for Jesus too. I started these Lent reflections by noticing that the chapter starts with Jesus full of the Holy Spirit. He knows who he is in relationship to God, and nothing that follows will shake that. Are we as confident in our relationship with God that no matter what happens, we are able to rest in the knowledge that we are children of God? Do we feel the need to prove that relationship to ourselves or others? Or will our faith hold even when we feel at our weakest? The first letter of John, chapter 3, starts with these words. See what great love the Father has lavished on us, that we should be called children of God. And that is what we are. Use this time of quiet to thank God for bringing you into his family and giving you assurance that you are loved by him. Almighty God, whose Son Jesus Christ fasted 40 days and 40 nights in the wilderness and was tempted as we are, yet without sin, help us to guard the inner space in our lives by keeping faithful to our life of prayer. Give us grace to discipline ourselves in obedience to your Spirit. And as you know our weakness, so may we know your power to save. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. As our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. In darkness and in light, in trouble and in joy, help us, Heavenly Father, to trust your love, to serve your purpose, and to praise your name. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.